गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू क्लास 12th. दिस इज़ योर चैप्टर 2 फ्रॉम योर बुक फ्लैमिंगो ऑफ इंग्लिश. सो टुडे विल स्टार्ट दिस चैप्टर एंड द चैप्टर नेम इज़ लॉस्ट स्प्रिंग. हियर इन दिस चैप्टर बिफोर स्टार्टिंग विद दिस पैराग्राफ्स एंड ऑल आई वुड लाइक टू टेल यू द थीम ऑफ द चैप्टर. Here, lost spring. This word lost means you all know that something which is not found. So that thing is lost thing. And here, spring. Spring is a name of a season where new buds are there in the flowers or branches of a trees. So with that, this is like, or the buds or the flowers are like the child of that particular tree or children of that particular tree. So here lost spring means lost childhood, that how childhood lost. And there are two themes in the chapter and there are two stories in this chapter. So this single chapter contains two stories. The first story is based on the theme of poverty and the second one is based on the child labor. So, after this, let's read the chapter, Stories of Stolen Childhood, that how childhood is stolen by, or childhood is stolen of some child. Here, there's an author in the story, her name is Annis Jung, 1964, was born in Rourkela and spent her childhood and adolescence in Hyderabad. So this Annis Jung, she was born in Rourkela and her childhood or most childhood memory or her teen or adolescence age is spent in Hyderabad, and then she received her education in Hyderabad and in the United States of America. Her parents were both writers. Like author, her parents were also writers. Annis Jung began her career as a writer in India. Annis Jung ने अपना खुद का करियर भी जो है she so the starting period of her career is in India. She has been an editor and columnist for major newspapers in India and abroad and has authored several books. So she is like the editor, the columnist, and she wrote several things for newspapers not only in India, also in abroad. The following is an excerpt from her book titled Lost Spring. This chapter is basically from her book, Annie's book, that is Stolen Childhood Story. Here she analyzed the grinding poverty and tradition which condemned these children to a life of exploitation. That how this सिचुएशन ऑफ पोवर्टी और गरीबी किस तरह लोगों की लाइफ को या बच्चों की लाइफ पे उसके क्या इम्पैक्ट्स होते हैं, या फिर किस तरह जो गरीबी है वो बच्चों की लाइफ पे कितना हद तक नेगेटिव इम्पैक्ट्स देती है. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट द चैप्टर. सम टाइम आई फाइंड अ रुपी इन द गार्बेज. हियर द फर्स्ट स्टोरी और द टाइटल ऑफ द फर्स्ट स्टोरी इज लाइक दैट, सम टाइम आई फाइंड अ रुपी इन द गार्बेज. So this story is basically based on those children who are like rag pickers, or you can say that children who pick up some garbage or try to find out something useful from the garbage. And students, you have already or you also have seen some kind of a people or some children, those who are picking up these kinds of things. So let's start the chapter. What do you do this? I asked Sahib, whom I encounter every morning scrounging for gold in the garbage dumps of my neighborhood. Here, the author of the chapter, she is asking some question with that boy, and the name of that boy is Sahib. So she asked with that boy that, what do you do this? Why do you do this? And Sahib, whom I encounter every morning, and Sahib is a name of a child, and author and that child, they met every morning, and at that time what that boy is doing. The boy is scrounging means he is trying to get things, especially money or kind of a food, by asking for them or instead buying for them. So he is doing that kind of a work for gold in the garbage dumps of my neighborhood. So he is trying to find something here. Find out something or find out gold from the garbage means ऐसा नहीं है कि वो garbage में से gold ही find out करा था. So garbage is like for those people who are like rag pickers, for them garbage एक ऐसी चीज़ होती है जिससे sometimes उनके it's like a treasure hunt for them. So sometimes उनके लिए ऐसा होता है कि when they are picking up something from the garbage, so कुछ ना कुछ उन्हें ऐसा useful या समथिंग जो उन्होंने नहीं देखा होता है या बहुत ही इम्पॉर्टेंट होता है वो उन्हें कहीं ना कहीं मिल ही जाता है. सो इट्स लाइक अ ट्रेजर हंट. और गार्बेज में से कुछ चीज़ें पिक करते करते उन्हें कभी कभी मनी, सम काइंड ऑफ गोल्ड आइटम्स, कुछ ना कुछ ऐसा मिल ही जाता है, या कुछ फूड आइटम्स और समथिंग इम्पॉर्टेंट. साहिब लेफ्ट हिज होम ऑल अलॉन्ग अगो. सो ही लेफ्ट हिज होम लॉन्ग अगो. Set amidst the green fields of Dhaka, his home is not even a distant memory. So here amidst means, so his home is surrounded by something like green fields of Dhaka. His home is not even a distant memory for him. There were many storms that swept away their fields and homes, and his mother tells him. So storms are there in that particular place Dhaka where they lived earlier, and in that there are lots of storms, and regularly there are storms are over there. That is why the fields and home are like swept away. तो storms के कारण या बहुत ज़्यादा हवाओं के कारण उनके घर जो हैं वो लोग बेघर हो गए थे. It's like that. His mother tells him and all the things which we'll get to know about all these things. ये सारी बातें जो child है साहिब उसको किसने बताई थी, उसकी mother ने. That's why they left looking for gold in the big city where he now lives. So इसीलिए वो अपना home town जो है ढाका में वो छोड़ कर, because उनके घर जो हैं वो climatic conditions की वजह से they are not there right now. So that is why they are switching over there in this city, big city where they are looking for gold, or where they are picking up some garbage over there and they are trying to picking up some important things from the garbage. I have nothing else to do, he mutters looking away. और उसने मन में ये कहते हुए कहा कि मेरे पास कुछ करने को नहीं था, I don't have any work, that is why I am doing this kind of work. Go to school, I say glibly, realizing immediately how hollow the advice must sound. Then, after hearing his reply, जो author हैं वो उसे बहुत ही fluent या बहुत ही smooth manner में कहते हैं. Here glibly means speaking in something which is very fluently. So she is saying or very smoothly that go to school, realizing, and after that जैसे ही वो कहती हैं that go to school, उसके बाद उसे realize होता है कि उसकी advice जो है वो कहीं ना कहीं that is not suitable at that time. There is no school in my neighborhood, when they build one I will go. Then after hearing author's word, that boy is replied to that lady is like, there is no school in my neighborhood. मेरे नेबरहुड में कोई स्कूल नहीं है. When they build one, I will go. जैसे ही वो स्कूल बनाएंगे then it's possible for me to go to school. Next one. Move on to next page. If I start a school, will you come? I ask, half joking. Yes, he says, smiling broadly. Here, the author of the chapter, she just convince that boy, if I'll start a school, will you come? I ask, half joking. जो author हैं उन्होंने उस बच्चे से कहा, साहिब से, if मैं school start करती हूँ then क्या तुम मेरे school में आओगे? Yes, he says, smiling broadly. Then वो बच्चा जो है साहिब, he replied that okay, I will surely come to your school. A few days later, I see him running up to me, "Is your school ready?" And after some few days, that kid, he's just running near author, and he asked her that, "Your school is ready, can I take admission in your school?" "It takes longer to build a school," I say, embarrassed at having made a promise that I was not meant, but promises like mine abound in every corner of his bleak world. So here narrator is saying that, or the author is saying that, it takes longer to build school because she knew that cake school banana is not an easy task. बहुत टाइम लगता है, बहुत मनी लगता है, एंड साथ साथ में बहुत ज़्यादा, देर आर लॉट्स ऑफ थिंग्स व्हेन वी और व्हेन समबडी इज़ लाइक बिल्ड अ स्कूल. सो दिस इज़ नॉट अबाउट ऑल अबाउट मनी, और इट्स नॉट ऑल अबाउट द मटीरियल. इट्स ऑल अबाउट दैट बिल्डिंग स्कूल इज़ नॉट अ ईजी टास्क. आई से एम्बेरस्ड एट हैविंग मेड अ प्रोमिस. नाउ ऑथर इज़ फीलिंग गिल्टी, एम्बेरस्ड हियर मीन्स शी इज़ फीलिंग गिल्टी दैट she made a promise which is like जो वो पूरा नहीं कर सकती थी. It's not possible for her to keep that promise or to complete that promise, and that is why she is feeling guilty at that time. But promises like mine abound in every corner of his bleak world. But वो साथ ही साथ ये भी जानती थी कि उसके उस जो promise narrator ने किया या author ने किया, these type of promises are like bleak. Bleak means not hopeful or not helpful for these kind of people. After the months of knowing him, I ask him his name. Sahibe Alam, he announces, he does not know what it means. If he knew its meaning, he does not know what it means. If he knew its meaning, Lord of Universe, he would have a hard time believing it, unaware of what his name represent. He roams the street with his friends, an army of barefoot boys who appear like a morning birds and disappear at noon. Over the months, I have come to recognize each of them. Here now, and the author is saying that after months of knowing him, जो ऑथर हैं वो रेगुलरली और फॉर फ्यू लाइक आफ्टर मंथ्स वो उससे मिलने लगे. आई आस्क हिम हिज नेम, एंड उसने ऑथर ने उसका नाम पूछा, यानी इसने, देन बच्चे ने रिप्लाई किया, साहिब आलम. ही अनाउंसेस ही डज नॉट नो व्हाट इट मीन्स, उसे पता नहीं था कि उसके नेम का मतलब क्या है. द मीन ऑफ और द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस वर्ड साहिब आलम मीन्स द लॉर्ड ऑफ यूनिवर्स. एंड इफ उस बच्चे को उसका मीनिंग पता चल जाता है, सो इट इज़ वेरी हार्ड टू बिलीव फॉर दैट किड दैट मेरे नाम का मीनिंग है लॉर्ड ऑफ यूनिवर्स. अनअवेयर ऑफ वॉट हिज नेम रिप्रेजेंट, ही रूम्स द स्ट्रीट. वो स्ट्रीट पर इधर से उधर अपने फ्रेंड्स के साथ घूमता है. एन आर्मी ऑफ बेयरफुट बॉयज़, यह बेयरफुट मीन्स नंगे पाँव जो है, विदाउट एनी स्लीपर और शूज़. द चिल्ड्रंस आर रोमिंग हियर एंड देयर ऑन द स्ट्रीट्स, who appears like a morning birds. And for author, the children or these street children, they look like a morning birds for her. Disappear at noon. Over the months, I have come to recognize each of them. And ये जो बच्चे ये जो morning में इतना जल्दी निकल जाते हैं to pick some garbage, ये noon time में सभी वहाँ से वहाँ पे नहीं रहते हैं. एंड ओवर द मंथ्स आई हैव कम टू रिकॉग्नाइज ईच ऑफ देम. और ना ऑथर को शी इज़ लाइक अ पर्सन जिसको इन बच्चों को रिकॉग्नाइज करने में, पहचानने में कुछ मंथ्स लगे. थैंक यू क्लास.